Hello traders, Rich here, and here's a quick but detailed update on KCS. As usual, if you guys like video analysis, let me know in the comments or simply leave a like. So let's get started. As we clearly see, KCS has been overall bullish for a while, making higher lows and higher highs trading inside this giant brown channel. And we are currently sitting around the upper bound, or what I consider an oversold area or non-horizontal resistance. So we are expecting a rejection from here, and as per our basic trading style, we'll be waiting for KCS to approach the lower bound or non-horizontal support to catch the next impulse movement upward, just like previously here, here and here. But we both know that KCS can still trade higher from here and make another parabolic movement just like this one. Tell you how. If we zoom in, we can see that this one has been trading upward in an aggressive manner, and we are now stuck inside this range. And when we are in a range after an impulse movement, we have two possible scenarios. The first one is a trade reversal. And in this case, we want a break below this entire range, a daily close above this green area, which is holding the price up. In this particular case, if this happens, then the correction would be confirmed that it's about to start, and we'll be looking for buy setups around the lower bound, as mentioned before from daily time frame. However, this one can still break the range upward. In this case, it would be an impulse correction and another impulse movement upward. If we zoom into H4 time frame, we can see that we have an ascending triangle forming. Let's wait for it. Here we go. And an ascending triangle is usually a trend following pattern. Of course, it can be broken from the downside, but it's usually a trend following setup. So we have this impulse. Now we're stuck inside this range of in the shape of an ascending triangle. And what does an ascending triangle mean anyway? It means that we have double tops, at least for now it's still forming, but we're inside a range and the buyers aren't strong enough, just like before, to be able to push the price higher. Instead, the buyers or the price is making equal highs. However, if we check the lows, we can see that the buyers are still pushing and they are even stronger inside this range because the buyers manage to make a higher low. So we are in a range, and usually we have a horizontal range, so we have equal highs and equal lows. However, when you see equal highs but higher lows, it means that we are inside a range, but the bulls are pushing and most probably we'll be seeing a breakout to the upside. But of course, we always wait for extra confirmation and trigger, which would be, and as mentioned previously, a break above the upper area. So our two possible scenarios are, if we have a break below the lower bound, below this green area, we'll be looking for buy setups around the lower bound of the daily time frame, the brown one and the blue zone. Or if we have a break to the upside above this ascending triangle, then the bulls would confirm to be in control again. In this particular case, we can expect another impulse movement upward. And for those who already know, for the ascending triangle, this is our projection. So we're expecting a massive movement upward. In this case, it would be an impulse correction. Then we would have the next impulse movement upward. So for now, let's wait which way this one is going to break. And good luck. I'll see you on the next one.